Dear students, today we shall attempt to learn about Hymenoptera. The name Hymenoptera is derived from the Greek words hymen means membrane and ptera meaning wings. It also has reference to Hymeno, the Greek god of marriage. The name is appropriate not only for the membranous nature of the wings but also for the manner in which they are joined together as one by the ammuli. As a rule, members of order Hymenoptera can be regarded as ecological specialists and are highly evolved. Most species are rather narrowly adapted to specific habitats and are specific hosts. Their remarkable success is a taxon, probably has more to do with their immense range of behavioral adaptation rather than any physical or biochemical characteristic. The Hymenoptera is the only order besides the termites to have evolved complex social systems with division of labor. Identification of Hymenopterans. Except in sawflies, the base of the abdomen is constricted in some distinctly thread-like, which is often referred to as the typical wasp waist. Antennal flagellum consists of a clavus, funicle and ring segments. In winged forms, the wings are membranous. Except for worker ants, most adult Hymenoptera have two pairs of wings. The front and hind wings are linked together by hooks or ammuli along the leading edge of the hind wings. This helps in catching into a fold near the back of the front wings. The wings contain relatively few veins and some minute forms have no veins at all. The mouthparts are mandibulate, but in many, especially the bees, the labium and maxilla form a proboscis, which is a tongue-like structure through which liquid food is taken in. Antenna is usually having 10 or more segments and are generally fairly long. The tarsi of leg is usually having 5 segments. The egg-laying organ called oviposter is generally well developed. In some cases, it is modified into a sting, which functions as an organ of defense and offense, as in the case of honeybees. Because the sting is derived from an egg-laying organ, only females have the sting. Habit and habitat of Hymenopterans. Because of the peculiar haplodiploid sex determination, several levels of sociality is seen. The males are produced by unfertilized eggs and hence are haploid, while female Hymenopterans are diploid. They are solitary, semi-social and eusocial forms. In some members like honeybees, an elaborate dance communication system is available. Some members of Formicidae, that is ants, show association with sucking insects like aphids. This group is extremely interesting in terms of their biology as they exhibit a great diversity of habits and complex social organization, especially ants, bees and the wasps. Importance of order Hymenoptera. Members of order Hymenoptera are probably the most beneficial in the entire class Insecta. There are many species that are very important as parasites and predators of several species of insect pests of crops, which have been successfully used in biological control programs. This group is also containing important pollinators of plants. Herbivory is seen among primitive Hymenoptera, especially suborder Symphyta, in the gall wasps, Cynipidae, and in some of the ants and bees. Coming to life cycle of Hymenopterans. Hymenopterans have a complete life cycle which varies slightly depending upon the species. Some females produce young ones without mating, while others can store sperm and spread out their egg laying to coincide with available food. Most species will lay their eggs on the appropriate host plant or on paralyzed food sources they have gathered into specially constructed nests. A variation of this occurs with social insects such as ants and bees, where special caches provide food for the developing larvae. The larvae will molt several times before they pupate. Development may range from a few weeks for some parasitoids to much longer duration in social species. Immature stages of Hymenoptera. Immature Hymenoptera look very different from adults. Most resemble grubs or maggots, but some such as sawfly larvae look very similar to caterpillars. Generally, immature Hymenoptera are not encountered because many are very small internal parasites of other insects are protected by adults, especially social wasps, bees and ants, and therefore they are left alone. Sawflies are erucifarum, caterpillar-like, well-developed egg capsule, chewing mouthparts with fleshy abdominal prolegs. Coming to bees and wasps, they are grub-like, well-developed head, chewing mouthparts, legless and eyeless. In case of parasitic wasps, the body forum is highly reduced, they lack head region, eyes and also appendages. Coming to pupa. Pupa is exudate, a cocoon is usually formed. It may be parchment-like in texture, made up of soil particles, or in stinging forms a thin silken lining within the larval cell. Certain ants form no cocoon. In Hymenoptera, females develop from fertilized eggs and males develop from unfertilized eggs. Since females control whether or not an egg is fertilized, they can regulate the sex ratio of their offsprings. The fairy flies, family Mimaridae, are probably the world's smallest insects. They parasitize the eggs of other insects. Some species of cuckoos, wasps, family Chrysididae, invade the nests of wasps or bees. They kill the larvae they find and deposit their own eggs on the stored provisions. This behavior is known as kleptoparasitism, and certain type of ants are also the only insects that can sting. Larvae of bee, ants and wasps do not form a complete digestive system until near the end of the pupal stage. Wastes accumulated by the larvae are excreted just before adult emergence. Female of some parasitic Hymenoptera produce extremely large number of eggs. Some parasitic wasps swim beneath the water to lay their eggs on aquatic prey. Charopractus cinctus, which belongs to family Mimaridae, is an egg parasitoid of water beetle belonging to genus Dytiscus. Fig wasps under family Agonidae are the only insects that can pollinate fig trees. The wasp's larvae, which develop within flower galls, become coated with fig pollen when they emerge as adults. They unintentionally cross-pollinate each flower they visit when laying the eggs. The Simna fig is a commercial variety that does not produce any pollen. Its survival depends entirely upon Blastophagus senis, a wasp that develops in wild capri figs but cross-pollinates the Smina fig. Defense mechanism exhibited by Hymenoptera. Venom production. Most of all Hymenoptera, even sawflies, which are phytophagous, have a venom gland associated with the ovipositor or sting. In parasitic wasps, the venom gland products are thought to be primarily associated with two roles: to help overcome the host's immune defense against the parasitoid's egg or larva, and sometimes, especially among ectoparasitic eidiobionts, to paralyze the host. Venom glands in aculeate wasps are the source of well-known pain-inducing toxins that many social and some solitary Hymenoptera use to such good effect in self-defense. Behavior exhibited by Hymenoptera insects. Hymenoptera display an array of interesting behavioral characteristics. Particularly in social species, the communication of honeybees by dance language from one individual to another about the location, distance, quantity and quality of particular food source. Progressive provisioning refers to a form of parental behavior in which an adult bee or wasps feeds its larva directly after they have hatched, feeding each larva repeatedly until it has completed development. Mass provisioning. It refers to a form of parental behavior in which an adult bee or wasps stocks all of the food for each offspring in a small chamber called cell prior to the laying of the egg. Trophallaxis. It is the mutual exchange of food between larvae and adults of bees, ants and wasps. Hyperparasitism. The parasitic habit of one species upon another parasitic species in some members of families Chalcididae and Proctotrupidae. Parthenogenesis. Production of young ones by females that are not fertilized by males are also found in some form of Hymenoptera. Collection and preservation of Hymenoptera insects. This group is generally found in different habitats and different collecting methods are used to collect them. They can be collected by sweeping on the vegetation, especially flowers. Passive collection techniques like beating, tapping, using malai straps, light traps, yellow pan traps, collecting balls, pitfall traps, etc. can be adopted. Parasitic species can be reared from parasitized hosts, especially eggs, larvae, nymphs or pupae. Burley's funnel can also be used to collect soil-dwelling Hymenoptera. The specimens can be pinned, mounted on paper points or preserved in alcohol depending upon their size. Classification of Hymenoptera, suborder Symphyta, Chalastrogastra. Here the abdomen is broadly attached to thorax. First abdominal segment is not fused with metathorax. Trochanter is always two segmented. Four tibia will have two spurs. Sensory is present. Oviposter is swallow-like. At least three basal closed cells are found on the hindwing. Larvae are erusiform, mostly phytophagous. Family Tenthredinidae, Dipryonidae and Orrusidae come under this. The first family, that is Tenthredinidae, are sawflies. They are small to medium-sized wasp-like insects. Antenna thread-like, usually nine-segmented. Four wings have one or two marginal cells. Females with saw-like oviposter. Anterior tibia will have two apical spurs. Example, mustard sawfly Athalia proxima lugens. The second family is Dipryonidae, conifer sawflies. They are stout-bodied insects. Antenna will have 13 or more segments, usually serrate in female and pectinate in male. Forewing will have one marginal cell, example Dipryon similis. The third family is Orrusidae, they are parasitic wood wasps. Antenna is inserted below the eyes under a broad frontal ridge. One subimaginal cell is found in the forewing. They are ectoparasitic on Buprestidae and Cerambycidae. They have got jerky movements to locate larval hosts. Eggs are laid in frass filled with burrows close to the host larvae. Suborder Apocryta. Here the abdomen is narrowly attached to the thorax. It is fused with metathorax to form propodium. Trochanter is one or two segmented. Four tibia with single spur. Sensory is absent. Oviposter is often modified into a sting or stinging organ. Almost two or no basal cells are found on the hindwing. The larvae are apodous, parasitic, predaceous or phytophagous. This suborder is further subdivided into two groups, that is Parasitica. Here the oviposter arises anterior to apex of metasoma, more or less permanently extruded, not modified into a sting, but can pierce insects for oviposition. Trochanter is two-segmented. It includes the families Evanidae, Ichneumonidae, Braconidae, Chalcididae and Cynipidae. The first family is Ichneumonidae, wherein two recurrent veins are found on the forewings. Antenna is long with 16 or more segments and it is usually filiform. Oviposter is neither as long as or longer than the body. Larvae are parasitic on immature stages of other insects. The example is Xanthopimpla punctata. The second family is Braconidae. It is a small, stout-bodied, dark or dull-colored wasp. One or two recurrent veins are present on the forewings. The second and third metastomatic tergites are fused. They are usually parasitoids of egg and larvae of other insects. Example, Brachymeria nymphantidis. The third family is Chalcididae. Here the adults are small, metallic and body is bare. Antenna is geniculate. Wings sometimes banded or spotted. No closed cells are often without veins. Hind femur is swollen with rows of short teeth and large hind coccyx. They are parasites of eggs and larval stages of other insects. Example, Brachymeria nymphantidis. The fourth family is Evanidae. It is otherwise called ensign wasps. They are black, somewhat spider-like in appearance. Abdomen is small, arising from dorsal aspect of thorax and carried like a flag. That is why they are called as ensign wasps. They are parasitic on cockroach, Utica, and are generally found in bathrooms and houses. Example, Evania appendigaster. Family fifth, that is Cynipidae, Here the antenna is slender, wing venation is reduced but not as greatly as in Chalcidoidea. Abdomen is usually oval and shining. Scutellum is often oval and elevated. They are gall wasps or gall makers or live in the galls of other gall making insects, mostly on hawks or rosaceae family members. They have very complex life cycles including parthenogenesis, alteration of sexual and sexual generations, multiple host plants, etc. The sixth family is Platygastridae. They are shining black wasps with reduced venation, some without any veins. Antenna is long, 10 segments attached very low close to the clypeus. Parasites of Cecidomyidae and Sternorhynchon Hemiptera. Example Platygaster oryzae. The seventh family is Trichogrammatidae. It is a metasoma broadly attached to the mesosoma. Tarsi of the leg is 3-segmented, wing venation is reduced, setae are arranged in lines. They are egg parasitoids mostly used for biological control of pests. Example Trichogramma chelonis. The eighth family is Mimaridae. They are called fairy flies. They are egg parasites of Odonata or Orthoptera, Socoptera, Orthoisenoptera, Hemiptera, Coleoptera, Lepidoptera and Diptera. They have a series of unique sulci on the head. One set is parallel to inner edges of the compound eyes on fronts and vertex. A distinctive transverse sulcus between eyes above the antennal insertions are found. Stalked parallel-sided hindwings are found. Narrow base of the forewing is seen. The ninth family is Agaonidae. They are otherwise called fig wasps. Head is longer or oblong with a deep longitudinal groove above. The front and hind legs are stout, mid legs are slender, tibia much shorter than the femur of the leg. Metasoma much drawn out to a point apically or broad at the tip. Antenna is short and stout, 3 to 9 segmented, example Blastophaga zenes. The 10th family is Eulopidae. They are mesopleuron with well developed groove for receiving mid femur. Antennal clave is short, second or third, 2 or 3 segmented. Tarsi of the leg is 4-segmented. Males have pectinate antenna. The 11th family is Aphalinidae. They are usually small or 1 mm in less in length. The number of segments in antenna is 8 or less. Tarsi is 5-segmented in the leg. Marginal vein is elongate. They are parasitic on scales, aphids, whiteflies, eggs of Hemiptera, Orthoptera and Lepidoptera. The example is Aphalinus mali. Aculeata. The oviposter arises from apex of metasoma. They can be withdrawn into the abdomen. They are modified for stinging. In some, both egg-laying and stinging, trochanter 1-segmented. The families under this are Chrysidae, Vespidae, Apidae, Formicidae, etc. The first family Formicidae. Here the first abdominal segment is node-like or with a dorsal hump differing from remaining segments. Antenna is geniculate in females. They are social insects with caches, queen, males and workers which are sterile females. The example is the red ant Ecophyllus margdina and Camponotus compressus which are called carpenter ants and Leptogenus processionalis. The second family is Vespidae which includes wasps. They are social insects with 3 caches, that is queen, workers and males. All of them are warningly banded with yellow on a black or brown background. 2 submarginal cells of equal length are found in the veins. Pollen is carried on underside of the abdomen, example Megachyla anthracaena. The third family is Apidae which includes honeybees, which you are all very familiar. Labrum broader than the long and body hairs are plumose in honeybees. Hind tibial spurs are absent. 3 submarginal cells with the third cell being oblique. Pollen carried between hind tibia and basitarsus. Inner margin of hind tibia provided with a comb of stiff setae. Social species with queen and worker cats and large colonies. The species are Indian bee Apis serrana, rock bee Apis dorsata, small bee Apis floria. In honeybee, there are some minor leg modifications. foragial legs are in which all the three pairs of legs of honeybees are modified to collect food. Four legs. The foreleg of honeybees has three important structures. The eye brush with hairs on tibia constitute eye brush, which is useful to cleanse the compound eyes. Antenna cleaner or strigilis. It consists of two structures, that is vellum and antennae comb. Vellum is a movable clasp present at the distal end of the tibia. Antenna comb is a semicircular notch lined with small spines. Antenna cleaner is useful to clean the antenna. Pollen brush. Bristles on basi tarsus form pollen brush, which is useful to collect pollen from the head and mouth parts. The middle legs in honeybees has two important structures. The pollen brush with stiff hairs on the basi tarsus form pollen brush, which is useful to collect pollen from middle part of the body. Tibial spur at the distal end of the tibia is a movable spur, which is useful to loosen the pellets of pollen from the pollen basket of the hind legs and to clean the wings and spiracles. Hind legs of honeybees have three important structures, that is a pollen basket, pollen packer and pollen comb. Pollen basket is also called carbiculae. The outer surface of the hind tibia contains a shallow cavity. The edges of the cavity are fringed with long hairs. The pollen basket enables the bee to carry a large load of pollen and propolis from the field to the hive. Pollen packer. It is also called pollen press. It consists of a pecten auricle. Pecten is a row of stout bristles at the distal end of the tibia. Auricle is a small plate fringed with hairs at the basal end of the basi tarsus. Pollen packer is useful to load pollen into the carbicula. The third structure is pollen comb. About 10 rows of stiff spines are present on the inner side of the hind basi tarsus. The pollen comb is used to collect pollen from middle legs and from posterior part of the body. The fourth family is family Chrysididae. They are called cuckoo wasps. They are green or blue-green with pitted thorax. Metasoma with 3 to 5 visible terga are seen. Last metasomal tergum is dentate apically. Head is not elongate. They do not sting. Antenna with 12 segments in females and 13 segments in males. Hind wings with no closed cells. Abdomen is concave beneath, allowing chrysalids to curl up into a ball when they are disturbed. Cuckoo wasp larvae are ectoparasites of bees and wasp larvae. Although some feed on walking stick eggs, Chrysis dorsalis. The fifth family under Hymenoptera is Bethylidae. They are small to medium sized wasps. Females in many species are wingless and they are like ants. Metasoma is with 6 or 7 visible terga. Antenna consists of 12 or 13 segments. The head is usually oblong, example Goniosus nephantidis, which is the parasitoid of coconut black-headed hairy caterpillar. The sixth family is Scolaidae. In this case, the wing membrane of forewing will have numerous wrinkles at the apex. They may have a notch in the anterior margin of the eye. They are ectoparasitoids of scarab grubs living in soil. The female insects burrow in the ground to sting and paralyze the host grub. The seventh family is Spicidae. Here the pronotum is short and collar-like with posteriorly directed round lobe. There are hairs on the body if present, and if not, they are plumose. The Hymenopteran predators are found in three important families, that is Formicidae, Vespidae and Spicidae. Formicidae, they are found in almost all places. They are eusocial insects which exhibit different forms. They have well-developed caste system. They feed on honeydew, seeds, insect eggs and larvae. In Yemen, the ants were introduced to control pests of date palm. In China, Ecophila smaragdina ant colonies were used by citrus growers for biological control of pests. The second family is Vespidae, which includes wasps. Some adult wasps provide their nests with paralyzed Lepidopteran larvae. They deposit eggs on these larvae to ensure food availability for the young ones. Wasps grub feed on caterpillars. Example, Polytus. The third family is Spicidae. They are called digger or spicid wasps. They are commonly found in summer They burrow tunnels in the soil and store their prey, which usually comprise of crickets, grasshoppers, flies, spiders, etc. Some Hymenopterans are parasitic. Parasitoid is an insect which is parasitic on another insect species. Parasitoids are recognized in 10 families under order Hymenoptera. The salient features of Hymenopteran parasitoid families are as follows. Family Braconidae, majority are beneficial groups of parasitoids. The adults are generally small and short as compared to ichneumonid flies. Many species are of considerable importance. They are ectoparasitoids or endoparasitoids. Their hosts include Lepidoptera, Coleoptera, Diptera, Hymenoptera, Hemiptera and Omoptera. Two common species are Brachan brevicornis on Lepidoptera and Apantelis flavipes on hairy caterpillars. Brachan brevicornis is reared on Carcera cephalonica under laboratory conditions, and they are used for control of BHHC, that is Opicina arenosella, on coconut in South India. The family Ichneumonidae or Ichneumon wasps, here the adults vary in size, color and form. Majority resemble wasps, differ from wasps in having very long antenna. Ichneumonids have two recurrent veins. Trochanter is two segmented, some are ectoparasitoids, several endoparasitoids seen and few are hyperparasites. They are parasitic on Lepidopterans, Coleopterans, Dipterans and Hymenopterans. Isotema javensis is an example. The third family of parasitoid Hymenoptera is family Trichogrammatidae. Here few species are egg parasitoids. They are very tiny, measure 0.3 to 1 millimeter in length, usually recognized by their three segmented tarsi and presence of microscopic hairs on the wings, which are arranged in rows, resembling the veins. The laboratory host for its mass multiplication includes Carcera cephalonica. Trichogramma species is usually recommended for biological control of a wide range of crop pests in sugarcane, cotton, maize, tomato and rice. The fourth family is Eulopidae, wherein black wasps, which are brilliantly colored tiny wasps with four segmented tarsi. They are egg larval or larvopupal parasitoids of Coleopterans, Lepidopterans, Dipterans and Omopterans. Trichospilus pupivora is an example on Opicina arenosella. The fifth parasitic Hymenopteran family is Eupelmidae. Here they are tiny brownish wasps. They are ecto or endoparasitic on Coleopterans, Dipterans, Hemipterans, larval parasitoids. Eupelma popa is the example. The sixth parasitic family is family Chalcididae. They are called chalcid wasps or flies. Hind leg femur is very much enlarged, with teeth-like structures beneath primary or secondary parasitoids of Lepidopterans or Dipterans, that is on larvae and pupae. Brachymeria is the example. The seventh parasitic family under Hymenoptera is Platygastridae. They parasitize small insects like Dipterans. They are minute, shiny, black insects with flattened abdomen. They are parasitic on Cecidomyids and sometimes on Omopterans. Polyembryony is common, that is one egg, several wasps are reproduced. Example Platygaster species on rice gall midge. The eighth family, which includes parasitoids under Hymenoptera, is Bethylidae. They are small to medium sized black brownish wasps with somewhat elongated head. They are parasitic on Coleoptera and Lepidopteran larvae. Example Pericereola nephantides on Opicina arenosella. The ninth family of parasitoids under Hymenoptera is Typhidae. They are ant-lion wasps, commonly called. Their body is elongated, blackish or brown in color. They are parasitic on root grubs or other Coleopterans or Hymenopterans. The tenth family is Scolidae. They are called scolid wasps. They are robust, large, hairy wasps, longitudinally wrinkled wings, parasitic on white grubs. Example is Scolia.